Hi guys, this is Avinash and you are welcome to another video of Easy Tutorials. Today in this video we will learn how to make a video sharing website using HTML, CSS and very simple JavaScript, and this website design is completely inspired by YouTube. As you can see on my computer screen, this is the website design that we are going to create in this video. First we have the top navigation bar with logo, one search box and some icons. Then we have the left sidebar with some useful links and list of subscribed channels. Just below this navigation bar, there is one large banner, and after this banner you can see the list of videos with their thumbnail image, video title, channel image and name, and number of views and upload time. When we scroll this website, you can see the top navigation bar and the left sidebar is sticky. They are not scrolling. That looks beautiful. Let me click on this menu icon so that you can see the left sidebar will collapse and it will hide the link text and it will only display the image and icons. When we click again on this menu icon, it will expand the sidebar. Let me change the screen size so that you can see this website design is completely responsive for smaller screen devices also. Let's click on this first video's thumbnail and it will open a new page. This is the video watch page where you can see the video that started playing automatically. We have these control options to play or pause the video. We can change the volume and we can also make it full screen by clicking on this icon. And again we can come back to the normal video size. Just below this video there are some tags, video title and some other video information. Here we have the like, dislike and share icons. After that, you can see the channel information, subscribe button and video description. After this video description, you can see one comment box and some list of comments. On this video watch page, we have added the sidebar in the right side where you can see the list of suggested videos with their thumbnail image and other video information. This page is also responsive for small screen devices. We will learn to make this complete website design using HTML, CSS and very simple JavaScript. Let me tell you, we are not building the functionality, we are going to create the front-end website design. So let's start making this website design like YouTube. Here I have this folder and in this folder you can see I have another folder with the name images. And in this one you can see I have the images and icons that I will be using on the website. I will give the images download link in the video description so that you can download the image and start making this website. Now I will open this folder with my code editor. Here I am using Visual Studio Code. You can use any code editor. Now we have to create a new file here and save this file as index.html, and here we will add some basic HTML structures. Next, we will create one more file and save this file as style.css. And here we will add star margin 0 and padding 0. We will also add font family. And let's add box sizing. These things will be applicable for all the HTML elements. Next, we have to connect this CSS file and this HTML file. For that, in this HTML file, we will add link rel styleset href and the file name, which is style.css. Now our HTML and CSS file is connected. Here we will change this title, so let me add another title here. Alright. Video sharing website, Easy Tutorials YouTube channel. Next, we have to open this website with our web browser. For that, just come back to the folder again, and here you can see this index.html file. Just you have to open this file with any web browser. Right click and select open with. I will select Google Chrome. And you can see this web page is blank right now. Here you can see the title on the top, which is video sharing website YouTube channel. And there is one another option to open this web page. Let's minimize this and come back to the VS Code again. Here click on this extension and here just search for live server. So this is the extension that you have to install, and after installing this extension, right click on the web page and you will find the option open with live server. Click here and it will open your website with the web browser, and in this way you don't have to refresh the website. Whenever you will edit the code and click on the save, it will automatically refresh your website. Let's come back and let's come to the CSS file. Here we will add some other code also, which will be applicable for complete web page. So here we will add a tag, which is anchor tag. And for this a tag, we will add text decoration, none. And we will add color. Next, we will add img so that it will be applicable for all the images that we will add on this website. For this image, we will add cursor pointer. So these were basic thing. Let's come back to the HTML file, and here we will add code that will be displayed on our website. So first we have to create one navigation bar. For that we will use the nav tag. And in this nav tag, we will add one menu icon, then we will add logo, then search box and some other icons. So we will divide this nav bar in three different div. So let's create one div here. And for this div, we will add the class name nav left, like this. And let me duplicate it, and this will be nav middle. And the last one, nav right. So in this nav, we have created three div. Now in the first one, we will add two images, that is one menu icon and another one for the logo. So let's add the img tag, write the image file path. So image is available in the images folder. So write the folder name images, write slash and the file name. So the file name is menu.png. Let's duplicate this line, and here we will change the file name. It will be logo.png to add the logo on this web page. After this, let's come back to the website again, and you can see this menu icon and this logo, right? And let's come back. Next, we will come to the last div, which is nav right, and in the right side we will add one image. So let me just copy this one, and here we will change the image file path. So we will add the another image name. It is upload.png, which is one upload icon. Let's duplicate it. And the next one will be more.png. This is the another icon. And after that, we will add another icon, notification. Notification.png. And then we will add one user's icon, which is jack.png. After adding this, let's check the website, and you can see we have other icons also just below this logo. Next, we will add some CSS properties to align all these things side by side. So just come back, and we have to add the display flex for this nav. We will be using flexbox on many places, on many layout on this website. So let me create one class name here, and I will add the class name flexdiv. Copy this one and write it here in this CSS file. So in this flexdiv, we will add display flex and align items center. After adding this, you can see these icons side by side. If you don't know about the HTML elements and CSS properties, I have a beginner video where I have explained all the HTML elements and most useful CSS properties. So just go and watch that video. I will give the video link in the description. So just go and watch that video, and after that you can continue this one. Next, just copy this tag nav and write it here. For this one, we will add some padding. So let me add the padding of 10 pixels from top and bottom, and we will add 2% from the left side and right side. Then let's add justify content space between, like this. And after that, we will add box shadow. In this box shadow, I will add 0, 0 and 10 pixel. Then we will add color in RGBA format. So this is the black color with 0.2 opacity. Then we will add the background. So the background will be white color. And we will add the position sticky, so it will not move. Whenever we will add position, we have to give the top. We can write 0, so it will be at the top only. And let's add z index 10. After applying this, let's come to the website again, and you can see there is one shadow at the bottom, and these elements are aligned left and right side, and we have some space from the left side and right side, which is 2% space. So let's come back, and here we will add this class name navWrite. Just copy this one, write it here. In this navWrite, we will add img. And for these images, we will add width. We have to decrease the size. So let me add the width of 25 pixel, and we will add margin from the right side. So there will be some space between the images. So it is also 25 pixel. You can see now these images size is good, but the last image size is very small. So we have to increase this one, and we will add some radius so that it will look circular. So just come back, come to the HTML file, and here we have the last image. So in this one, let me add one class name. I will add the class name user icon, like this. And now we will add the CSS properties for this class name, which is user icon. So copy this one, write it here. Before this one, I will add this class also, which is the parent class for this one. Navwrite, then user icon. So in this one, we will add width. We have to increase the width. So I will add 35 pixels and border radius. Border radius will be 50%, so it will be circular. And after that, we will add margin right. So the margin right will be 0. There will be no space in the right side. Now you can see the last image in the circular style and it looks good. Next, you can see the vertical alignment is not good for these elements, these images, this upload icon and bell icon and this user icon. So just come back and we have to add the same flex class name, which is flex div. Copy this one and add it in the last div, which is navwrite. So after that, add some space and add the another class name like this. Now you can see this alignment is perfect. Next, we will add the CSS properties for the left column. So let's come back. And here you can see we have two images. So in the first one, we will add the class name menu icon. And in the second one, let's add the class name logo, which is logo for this website. Next, we have to add the CSS for this one. So let's copy this class name, navleft, write it here. And in this one, we have the class name. Menu icon, copy this one, write it here. And for this menu icon, we will add width. So let's add the width of 22 pixels. Then we will add some space from the right side. So I'm adding margin right. So it is 25 pixels. Now this icon size is good. Next, we have to reduce the size of this logo. Let's come back and copy this nav left. Then write the class name logo. For this logo, let's add the width. I will add the width of 130 pixel. It is good. But again, you can see the alignment for this menu icon and this logo is not good. This logo is little bit upward and it is little bit down. So just come back and copy this class name flex div, add it here after this nav left. We have added this class name flex div. After that, let's refresh the web page and you can see this top navigation bar looks good. Next, we have to add the content in the middle of this nav bar, where we will add the search box and we will also add one mic icon. For that, let's come back. Let's add a space in this middle div. Here we will add some contents. So in this one also, we will add the same class name, which is flex div. Write it here. So we have two class name in this middle one. And now let's add another div with the class name search box. And with this search box, again we will add this class name flex div. Now within this search box, we will add one input field and we will add one search icon. So let's add one input. Input type will be text and we will add placeholder. So in this placeholder, we will add text search. And after that, we will add one search icon. For that, we will add the image tag, then image file path, images slash search.png. Now, after closing of this search box div, you can see the search box div is closing here. So let's add a space, and here we will add another icon, which is voice search icon, which is mic icon. So add the image tag, image file path, it is voice search.png, and we will add one class name for this one. So let me add the class name mic icon. After adding this, let's check the website again, and you can see one search box, one search icon, and one voice search icon. Next, we have to add the CSS properties for this one. So let's come back and copy this class name nav middle, write it here in this CSS file, and in this nav middle we have the class name called mic icon. So just copy this, write it here. For this mic icon, we will set the width. So let me add the width of 16 pixel so that it will be small. Now you can see the small search icon, I mean voice search icon. Let's come back, and here we will add this class name again, and after that just copy this class name, which is search box. Copy this, paste it here. For this search box, we will add border. So I am adding border of 1 pixel solid and this color code CCC. Then we will add some margin from the right side so that there will be some space between the search box and mic icon. So let's add the margin of 15 pixel from the right side. Then we will add some padding so there will be some space inside the search box, 8 pixel from top and bottom and 12 pixel from left and right side. Then we will add border radius 25 pixel. Let's check the website. It looks like this one. Next, we will add the CSS for this input box. Let's come back, copy this one, and in this one we have the input tag. So add the input. For this input, we will set the width. So let me add width of 400 pixel and border will be 0 and outline also 0. Then let's add the background, it is transparent. After that, you can see this search box looks good. Next, we have to add CSS for this search icon. Let's come back, copy this one, then write img, and here we will add width of 15 pixel. Now the search icon is small and this complete top navigation bar is looking beautiful. So we have added all the content in this top navigation bar and we have properly designed it using CSS. After completing this top navigation bar, we will add this sidebar in the left side. So let's come back and come to the HTML file, and you can see this nav tag is closing here. So after closing of this nav tag, let's add one comment. I will add the comment sidebar. and here we will create another div. Let's create the div with the class name sidebar. And in this sidebar, there will be some shortcut links and there will be some subscribed channel list. So first we will add one div with the shortcut links. And in this one, let's add one a tag. Let's add one image tag here and write the image file path images slash home dot png. And we will also add one title. So we will add this title in p tag. It is home. Like this. Let's refresh the website and you can see this home icon and this text. Similarly, we will add other icon and text also. So just come back and duplicate this line and change the image and change the text. It is explore. Then the next one is subscription. Then the next one is library. The next icon is history. Next icon is playlist. Next one is message.png. And the text is messages. Let me add one more. After adding all the icons and text, let's refresh the website again. And you can see more icons and text in the left side. Next, we have to add the CSS properties for this one. So let's come back and copy this class name sidebar. Come to the CSS file. Here also we will add one comment. After that, add this class name sidebar, and for this one we will add the background. It is white. Then let's add the width for this sidebar. So I will add the width of 15%. Then height. So the height will be 100 VH. Then position. So the position will be fixed. Top, it will be 0. And let's add some padding from the left side. It is 2%. And padding from the top. pixels. Like this. This logo and menu icon is hidden. So let's come back and we will check the nav. Here we have added static. It will be sticky. Just correct this one. Now you can see this logo and menu icon is visible. Let's come back. And here we will add this class name shortcut links. Write it here. And in this one we have the anchor tag, which is a tag, then img for the images. So for this image, let's add width. I will add the width of 20 pixel and some space from the right side. So let's add the margin of 20 pixel from the right side. Then let's copy this one, write it again. For this a tag, let's add display. It will be flex and align items will be center. Margin from the bottom 20 pixel and width it will be fit content. Flex wrap will be wrap. Now it is looking good. Next, for the first one, we have to change the color in the home text. So let's come back, copy this one. Here we will add first child. So it will select the first anchor tag. For this one, we will add the color code. Now you can see the first text is red. After that, we will add one horizontal line below this text. So just come back and come to the HTML file and add a space here. Just add HR. You can see one line here. Next, we have to design this line. So just come back. Copy this sidebar, then write HR. Border will be 0, then height it will be 1 pixel, background CCC and width. Let's add the width of 85%. So this line looks good. Next, we will add one title here and after that we will add list of subscribed channels. So just come back, come to the HTML file and you can see this div is closing here, shortcut links. So after that we will create another div and let's add the class names. Subscribed list. In this one, we will add one title in H3 tag. So the title is subscribed. After that, just copy this one line, paste it here. And here we will change the image like this. And we will change the text. Now you can see this title, this image and this text. Similarly, we will add other image and text also. So just come back, duplicate this line. Change the image. Now you can see other images also. Let's come back and copy this class name subscribed list. Come to the CSS file, write this class name here, and here let's add h3 for the title. For this title we will add the font size of 13 pixel. Then we will add margin. Let's add the margin of 20 pixel from top and bottom and left right 0. Then we will add the color. Write this class name again. Then write a tag. For this a, we will add display flex. Align items center, margin from the bottom, it will be 20 pixel, width it will be fit content, and flex wrap. Let's copy it again. And in this a tag we have the image also, so write img, and for this one we will add width. It will be 25 pixel and border radius. So the border radius will be 50%, so it will be circle, and we will add margin from the right side, 20 pixel. Now it is looking good. After adding all the contents in this sidebar, next we have to add the click event on this menu icon, so that whenever we will click on this icon, it will collapse the sidebar, and whenever we will click again, it will again expand the sidebar. For that we will use the small JavaScript. So just come back, come to the HTML file, and we can write the JavaScript code just before this closing body tag. We can add a script tag and we can add JavaScript code in this one, or we can also create a new page for the JavaScript. So let me create a new page. I will save this page as a script.js, like this. And here we will create one variable and add the variable name menu icon equal to document.querySelector. And in this one we have to add the class name of the menu icon. Let's come back and you can see where we have the menu. Here it is. Copy this class name, write it here with a dot. So we have stored this one in a variable. Let's duplicate it, and here we will add sidebar. And let's add the class name sidebar. Let's remove this one. Here we will add menu icon dot onClick equal to function, and in this function we will add some code that will be executed whenever we will click on the menu icon. So what will happen when we will click on this icon? We have to change the width of the sidebar. For that we will use one extra class name. So let's add this sidebar dot class list dot toggle. And in this toggle we will add another class name. So here we can create any class name. So let me add the class name small sidebar, like this. So whenever we will click on the small icon, it will add the small sidebar class, and if it is already there, it will remove that. That is how this toggle works. But right now this JavaScript will not work because we have not connected this JavaScript file with the HTML file. So just come back to the HTML file, come to the bottom. Before this closing body tag, we will add script. Script, and in this script, let's add src and add the file name, which is script.js. Now the HTML file and the script.js file is connected. Now let's come to the JS file again, and you can see we have added this class name here, but for this class name we have not added any CSS property. So just copy this one, come to the CSS file, and in this CSS file add this class name. Now here you can see for this sidebar we have added width of 15%. So what will happen whenever we will click on the menu icon, the width should be decreased. So in this small sidebar we will add width of 5%, like this, and let's come back. You can see if I click here, the width is changing. Let's come back and copy this class name again, and here we will add a tag, and in this a tag we have the p where we have added the title for all the links. So in this p we will add display none. So whenever the sidebar will be small, the p tag will be hidden, and we will also hide the title, which is in the h3. Copy this one and write h3 display none, and we have to decrease the size of the horizontal line. You can see this horizontal line size is big, so we have to decrease the size, and we will also add some space from the bottom. So let's come back, copy this one, then write hr. For this horizontal line we will add width of 50%, and we will add margin from the bottom 25 pixel. Just we have added this one, and after that you can see this sidebar works fine when we click on this menu icon. After creating this sidebar, we will add content in the complete web page where we will display the banner and we will display the list of videos with their thumbnail image and title and other information about the video. So let's come back, come to the HTML file, and you can see this sidebar is closing here. So let's add a space here, and here we will add one comment. Let's add the comment main. And here let's create one div. So let me add the div with the class name container. In this one we have to add one banner, so let's add another div with the class name banner, and in this one we will add one image, so let's add img tag image file path, which is images/banner.png. After adding this, let's refresh the website. You can see this image looks very big, so let's come back and copy this class name container, come to the CSS file. Here also we will add one comment. Let me add main, and after that add this class name container. For this container we will add background. Let's add the background of this color, Then we will add some padding from the left side. So in the left side, we have added the sidebar of width 15%. So here we will increase the padding from the left side. We will add padding 17%, because the 15% space will be used by left sidebar. Then we will add some padding from the right side. So let's add the padding right 2%. And after that, we will add padding from top. It will be very small, 20 pixels. And we will add the same padding from the bottom, 20 pixels. After that, we have this class name banner. So just copy this one, paste it here. For this banner, let's add the width of 100%. And in this one, we have the image. So just write this class name again, then write img. For this one, let's add width of 100%. Then we will add border radius. After that, let's refresh the website, and you can see this banner size is perfect. Next, we will add list of videos below this banner. So let's come back, come to the HTML file, and you can see this banner is closing here. So let's add a space, and here we will create another div. So let me add the div with the class name list container. In this one, we will add multiple videos. So let's add another div, and here we will add the class name vidList, which is video list. So it will be the first video. In this div, we will add everything or the single video. So first we will add one image, which will be the thumbnail image. So I'm adding img tag images slash thumbnail1.png, and we will also add one class name. So the class name I'm adding thumbnail. Like this. And after that, we will add another div. So let's add a div here. And for this one, we will add one class name. So we will use the same class name, which is here, flexDiv. Copy this one, write it here. In this div, we will add one user's image or channel image, and we will add information about that video. So first we have to add one image. So I'm adding the image tag, then image file path slash this one. And after that, let's add another div, and I will add the class name vidInfo, where we will add all information about the single video. So in this vidInfo, we will add the video title. So we will add one a tag, because the title will be clickable. We can click on that title. So let's add the title. After that, we will add the channel name in p tag. I will add my channel name Easy Tutorials, and let's add one more p tag, and in this one we will add number of views. Let's add 15k and views. let's add 2 days. After adding all these things, refresh the website and you can see it looks like this one. We have to add the A tag for this thumbnail image also so that we can click on the image. So just come back and you can see we have added this thumbnail image. So here let's add one A tag and we will add this image in this A tag like this. After that, let's copy this one list container, paste it here. Here we will use display grid so that it will be a responsive layout. Display will be grid and grid template column. Repeat. It will be auto fit. Min max 250 pixel, comma 1 FR, which is 1 fraction. If you have difficulties with this grid layout, I have a dedicated video for this one. You can go and watch that video so it will be clear. Then let's add grid column gap. It will be 16 pixels. And let's add grid row gap. Pixel. Then we will add some margin from the top. It will be 15 pixel. After that, just come back and you can see we have the class name widlist. Just copy this one, write it here. In this one we have added image with the class name thumbnail. So let's copy this, write it here, and for this thumbnail we will add width. It will be 100%, and we will add border radius of 5%. Let's come back and you can see here we have the class name flexdiv. So come to the CSS file again. Write this widlist, then write flexdiv. For this one, we will add align items. It will be flex start, and we will add margin from the top, 7 pixel. Let's refresh the website and you can see it looks so big because we have only one video list in this grid. We will add at least 4 video list. Then you will see it will look perfect. Let's come back. Here we have added this widlist, which is the single video. So just duplicate this to add multiple videos. Copy and paste. And we will add different images. It is thumbnail 1.png, it is thumbnail 2.png, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now you can see the thumbnail size is good. Next we have to add the CSS for this user's image, which is a channel profile image. So let's come back and come to the CSS file. Here we have added border radius 5%, so let me change it to 5 pixels. Now it is good. Let's come back and here we will add this class name, and in this one we have the image, so I am adding img tag. Let's add the width, it will be 35 pixels. Then we will add margin from the right side, 10 pixels, and border radius 50%. Now it is looking good. Next we will add CSS for these channel name, this a small text, and this a tag also. So let's come back and copy this class name, vid info, copy this one, paste it here. For this vid info, let's add the color. We will add the color, this one. Then we will add font size. Font size will be 13 pixels. Let's copy this class name again, then write A, because we have one title in A tag. And here we will add color, so the color will be black 000, and font weight it will be 600, display it will be block, and margin from the bottom it is 5 pixels. Now it is looking good. Next we have to add one dot between this views and time. So just come back to the HTML file, and where it is, here we will add one dot. To add that, let's add here we will add an bullet point. Now you can see one dot here in the first one. Similarly, we will add the same thing in other one. Let me copy this line only, paste it here. Now it is fine. Next you can see, if I click on this icon, we have the blank space over here. So we have to increase the width of this container whenever we will click on this icon and the sidebar is small. Means whenever the sidebar will be small, this container should be large. So let's come back, and in this CSS file you can see we have added container here. So let's add one more class name. I will add a space here, and here we will add the class name large container, like this. And in this one we have to add the different padding. So you can see we have added padding of 17%. So in this large container we will reduce the padding, it will be only 7%, like this. Next we have to apply this class name through the JavaScript. So let's come back in this JavaScript file. Here you can see we have created some variables, so let me duplicate this line, and here we will add container. And the class name container. So next we have to add the CSS In this one, we have to add another class name. So write this container here, then write dot class list dot toggle. And here we will add the same class name that we have just written here. Large container. There will be no dot here. Remove this dot. Simply add the class name. So we have added just two lines in this JavaScript. After that, refresh the website and you can see if I click on this menu icon, this sidebar becomes a small and this main container becomes large. And right now you can see total 5 videos in one row. So it is responsive also. So up to this it is working fine. Next we have to check this website on a smaller screen. So let me change the screen size. And you can see it looks like this one. So it is not looking good. We have to fix this one. And for this one, we will use the media query. So let's come back, come to the CSS file, and here let's add media, then write max width, let me add the max width of 900 pixel. Now we will add the CSS properties in this media query, and that will be applicable only for the device having width less than 900 pixel. So in this one you can see we have the menu icon. So we have to add this sidebar menu and this menu icon for a smaller screen. So just come back and let's add that class name menu icon, and we will add display none like this. After that we have to hide the sidebar also. So write sidebar and it is also display none. Let's check the web page. Now you can see there is no sidebar, but still we have some space from the left side. So we have to remove this space. So just come back and here we will add the class name dot container, and we will also add the class name dot large container. For these two div we have added the padding from the left side and right side, so we will change that one. We will add padding left, it will be 5%, and padding right also 5%. Now we have the proper required space from the left side. Now you can see these icons on the right side of the top navigation bar that we have to hide. So just come back and here we will add the class name dot nav right and write img, and let's add display none. So it will hide all the images in the right side of the top navigation bar. You can see images are hidden, so we have to display the user's image. So just come back and here we will add the same class name, and in this one we have added one class name for the user's icon, which is user icon. So let's add display, it will be block, and we will change the size. So we will add the width 30 pixel. Now you can see this user's icon is visible. Next we have to fix the width of this search box. So let's come back and here we will add the class name nav middle, because we have added the search box in this one. Then we have the class name search box and write input. So For this input box, we will decrease the width. So let's add the width of 100 pixel. Now you can see this search box width is small. Next, we have to hide the mic icon from here. So let's come back and here let's add dot nav middle, then write dot mic icon. Let's add display none, so it will be hidden. And right now this logo is big for a smaller screen, so we will decrease the size of this logo. So let's come back and here let's add the class name logo. For this logo we will add width, so the width will be 90 pixel. Now it is good. Let me scroll this web page and you can see all the alignments are perfect. We can change the screen size like this also. So we have completed the front page of this website design. Next we will create the other page where we will display the video and we will add the video information, comments and suggested videos. To create a new page, we will create a new file. So let's create a new file and save this file as playvideo.html. You can write any name, but the file name extension should be .html. We are creating one HTML file. Here also we will add the basic HTML codes. And let's add a title here. Play video. Easy Tutorials YouTube channel. Write any title. And next we have to connect the CSS file with this HTML file. So again we will add the link tag and the file name, which is style.css. After that we will come to the body tag and here we will add the navigation bar. So in the index.html file we have already created the navigation part, so just copy and paste in new page. You can see it is the navbar. Let's copy this one and paste it here in this new HTML file. Like this. Next we will open this page. To open this one, let's come to the HTML file and here we have added the video list. So this is the first video, vid list, and here we have added the A tag. In this anchor tag, we will add the file name of the new HTML page. So let's add the file name playvideo.html like this, ahref playvideo.html. So whenever we will click on this thumbnail, it will open a new page. Let's copy this one and we will add the same file name in this title also, ahref, and write the file name playvideo.html. So it will connect the next page with this link. Let's come to the web page and you can see here we have the first video where we have added the new page link. Let me click on this thumbnail. Now we can see the new page. It is playvideo.html and here we have the navigation bar that we have just copied. After adding this navigation bar, we will add other contents on this new page. So let's come back. Come to the playvideo.html. After closing of this nav, let's add some space and here we will create another div, and with this div we will add a class name that we have already used, which is container. And in this one, we will add one row, and in that row, there will be two columns. In the left column, we will add a video, then channel information and comments. And in the right column, we will add list of videos, which is suggested videos. For that, first we will create one div with the class name row, like this. And in this row, I told you, we will add two columns. So let's add the first div and write the class name play video. So this is the first column. Let's duplicate it and change the class name. It will be right sidebar. So in this row, we have added two columns. And in the first one, which is the left side, play video, in this one, we will add some contents. So first we have to add one video. So let's add a video tag like this. And with this video tag, we will add some controls. So just add controls, and we will also add autoplay like this. After that, here we will add the source file of the video. So write source src and write the file path. So let's come back to the folder. Here you can see we have the file name images, and in this one we have the video file called video.mp4. So we will add the same thing, folder name images / video.mp4. After that, we have to add the type. So the type is video / mp4. After adding this, if I come to the website again, you can see this video. But right now you can see there is so much a space from the left side because we have added padding left 17% for the container. So we have to reduce this one for this page. So let's come back, and with this container, we will add one more class name. So let's add the class name play container like this. And now we will come to the same CSS file, and let's add a space. First we will add one comment. So the comment I'll add play video page, because we are writing CSS for the new page. Now just add that class name, and for this one we have to reduce the padding from the left side. So we will add the padding left of 2%. Now it is good. On this video, you can see we have the control options to play and pause this video, and we have this volume control option. We can mute this video and we can unmute, and we can also increase and decrease the volume, and we can click on this icon to make it full screen, and let's click here to come back to the normal size. Now this video width is very large, so we have to fix the width for the left column and right column, and we will also add the CSS for the row. So let's come back, and first we will add the class name row in this CSS file. For this one, let's add display flex. Then we will add justify content. So it will be a space between, and flex wrap, it will be wrap. After that, let's come back to the HTML file again and copy this class name play video, which is the left side column. Write it here. And for this one, we have to add the width. So here we will add the flex basis. Flex basis, I will add the 69%. And now we will add the second one, which is this class name, right sidebar. So for the right sidebar, we will add again flex basis. So you can see in the left side we have added 69% and in the right side we have added 30%. So we have 1% space left. So we will get the space between the left and right side with 1%. And let's copy this class name again. And in this one we have added one video tag. So write the video, and for this video we will add width 100%. That's it. And now let's refresh the website. You can see the size of this video is perfect. Now we will add some list of videos in the right side. So let's come back to the HTML file. And in this div right sidebar, let's add a space. And here we will add one div with the class name side video list. And in this one, we will add one thumbnail image and video information. So first, let's add one image. Image file path. And next we will add some information about this video. So let's add one class name for this one. Div with the class name vidinfo. Now in this vidinfo we will add the title of the video, then we will add the channel name, and we will add the views. So we will add the title in a tag. And in this title, let's add the text. After this, we will add channel name in p tag. And let's add views. It is in the p tag. And we will also add one anchor tag for this image so that we can click on this image. So let's add a tag and add this image within this a tag. Now just come back and you can see the other image and video information just below the main image. So just come back and we will add one class name here. For this A tag, we will add the class name small thumbnail. So that we can add CSS properties for this image. And right now let's copy this class name side video list. Write it here in this CSS file. Here let's add display flex. Justify content will be a space between. And we will add margin from the bottom. 8 pixels. And just copy this class name again, then write img For this image, let's set width. It will be 100%. Now you can see this image in the right side and these other information. Now we have to design the left column and right column for this video information and thumbnail image. Let's come back and here we will add this class name, side video list. Then write the other class name, which is small thumbnail. For this image, we will add the class name and here we will add flex basis. Let's add the flex basis of 49%. And let's add this class name again. Now let's add the class name for the second column, which is vidInfo. And here also we will add the flex basis of 49%. So we will get 2% space between the left and right column of this small thumbnail and video info. You can see we have some space between this thumbnail image and this video title. Next, we will duplicate this div to add multiple images in the right side. So just come back, come to the HTML file, and here we have the side video list. So just we have to duplicate this one. Now we will add the other images. It is thumbnail 2, 3, 4, this is 5, this one is 6.png, 7.png and 8. This is, let's say, 1.png because we have only 8 image. Now you can see multiple thumbnail images on the right column. And you can go and change each title and views one by one. So next we will add the other information in the left column just below this video, where we will add the tags and we will add video title. So let's come back, come to this HTML file, and this is the right sidebar. So let me just collapse this one so it will be hidden. We don't have to do any changes in this one, so it will look clear. And let's come to this div, which is play video. In this one we have added video, so after this closing video tag, let's add a space. And here we will add another div. So we will add a div with the class name tags, and in this one we have to add tags. So let's add a tag. And in this A, we will add hashtag coding. Copy this one, then write other text here. It will be HTML. Next tag is CSS, the next one is JavaScript. You can see these tags below the video, and you saw the video was automatically playing when we refresh the web page. Next we have to design these tags. So let's come back and we will copy this class name, play video, and in this one we have the tags. Come to the CSS file, write this class name, then we will add tags and a tag. Here we will add color, then let's add font size. It will be small, 13 pixel. Now you can see the color for this tag. After this tag, we'll add title of the video. So let's come back, and here after this tag we will add title in h3. Write any title, and you can see this title just below this tag. Let's come back, and we have to add the CSS properties for this one. So come to the CSS file, write it here, then write h3. For this one we will add font weight 600, then we will add font size, it will be 22 pixel. Now the font size is good. After that we will add views on this video, and we will add time, and we will add some icons to like, dislike and share this video. So let's come back, and we will add all these things in a div. So let's create a div with the class name, let's say play video info. Like this, and in this one let's add a p tag, and in this paragraph tag we will add the number of views. Like this, and again we will add a bullet point. So let's add and this one, and write the time 2 days ago. You can see this text here. Let's come back, and here we will add a div. We will not add any class name for this div, and let's add one a tag, and in this a tag we will add one image. In this src let's add the file path images/, and write the icon file name. Let's see what is the icon file name. It is dislike.png, like.png, and we have share.png, and this one save.png. So we will add all these icons. It is like.png, and we will also add a text. So let's add the text of 125. Just duplicate it, and it is dislike. Then we will add another icon, which is share, and let's add the text share. The next one is save.png. And the text is save. After adding this, you can see these icons here. Next we have to add the CSS properties for this one. So let's come back and copy the class name play video info. Copy this one, come to the CSS file, and before that we will add the class name play video, and write this one play video info. Here we will add display flex and align items, it will be center. Then we will add justify content space between. After that we will add flex wrap, it will be trap. Then we will add margin from the top, margin top of 10 pixels, so we will get some space from the top. And after that font size, let's say 14 pixel, and here we will add the color. So this is the color. After that, you can see here is the text and here is the icons. It is in the right side. Now we have to change the size of these icons. So let's come back again and copy this one. In this one, we have added a tag, and in this a tag, we have added images with the img tag. So for this image, we will add width 20 pixels. So the images will be small, and we will add some space between the image and text. So let's add the margin right. So we will get a space from the right side, which is 8 pixels. You can see these icons are small. Now the alignment is not good. You can see it is little bit up and this text is down. So we have to align everything in the same horizontal line. So let's come back, copy this one. And for this one, we will add display inline flex. Align items center, and we will add margin from the left side. It will be 15 pixels. Now it is looking good. Next, we have to add one horizontal line over here. So let's come back, come to the HTML file, and after this div, you can see this div is closing here, play video info. So here we will add HR. Now you can see one line over here. Next, we have to add the CSS for this line. So just come back to the CSS file. Here we will add the parent class name, which is play video, then write HR, and let's add border 0. Then we will add height of 1 pixel. Then background, this color code, which is CCC, and we will add margin. So let's add the margin of 10 pixel from top and bottom and 0 pixel from the left and right side. So this horizontal line is also looking good. After this line, we will add the publisher information. Like we will add channel image, then channel name, subscriber, and one subscribe button. So first we will create one div. Let's come to the HTML file. After this HR, we will add another div with the class name publisher. And in this one, first we will add one image, which is the channel's image. Write the image file path. And after that, we will add channel name and subscribers together. So we'll add a div, and in this div, we will add P. In this P, let's add the channel name. And let's add the subscriber. And after this div, we will add a button, which is subscribe button. And in this button, let's add type. Type will be button, and button text will be subscribe. After writing this, let's come to the web page. You can see the image, channel name, and subscriber, and one button. So now we have to design this one. So let's come back and copy this class name publisher, write it here in this CSS file. For this publisher, we will add display flex. Then we will add align items center, and we will add margin from the top. So we will get some space from the top. Let's add 20 pixels. Next, add this publisher again and then write div. For this div, we will add flex 1. After adding this, you can see we have the image here. After that, we have this text and this button in the right side, because this div having the channel name and subscriber is using the entire available space. That's why this button is in the right side because of the flex one. And now let's copy this publisher again. Then write img, and for this image we will set width, let's say 40 pixel, then border radius 50%, and margin from the right side it is 15 pixel, border radius. Here it is border radius. Now it is round. Margin left. No, we will add margin right. It is good. Next, we have to add the CSS for these text. So let's come back, and here we will add line height of 18 pixel. Let's copy it again. Here we will add p. In this p we will add color. It will be black color, which is 000, and font weight. Then we will add font size. It in pixel. This channel name is looking good. Next, we will add the CSS properties for this text, which is number of subscribers, and it is in the span. So let's come back, copy this one, and then write span. Here we will add small font size. So let's add the font size of 13 pixel. And we will add different color. So it is good. Next, we have to design this subscribe button. So let's come back, copy this class name publisher, then write button. And for this button we have to add background, so the background will be red color. Then we will add color, which is the button color, button text color, which is white. And let's add some padding. And the padding is 8 pixel from the top and bottom, and 30 pixel from left side and right side. It is looking like this. So let's come back again, and here we will add border 0. And we will add outline 0. Then border radius, it will be 4 pixel, and cursor pointer. Now this subscribe button is looking good. After adding this channel information, we will add the video description. So let's come back, come to the HTML file, and here you can see this publisher div is closing here. So after that, let's create another div. Let's add the class name vid description. In this vid description, we will add text in p tag. So this is the text. After adding this two line, you can see it is coming here. Next, we have to design this one. So let's come back and copy this class name with description. Write it here in this CSS file. For this with description, we will add some padding from the left side. So this description will start from here, just below this channel name. So let's add padding from the left side. It is 55 pixel, and we will add margin. So let's add the margin of 15 pixel from top and bottom and 0 from left and right. So it is here. Now we will change the color of this text, and we will change the font size also, and we will add some space. So just come back, copy this one, then write P. For this one, let's add the font size of 14 pixel. Then we will add margin from the bottom. Let's add 5 pixel, and we will add color. Now it is good. After this text, we will add one horizontal line. So let's come back, and in this one, just after this P, we will add HR. After adding this, you can see there is one horizontal line here. It is looking good. And after this one, we will add one title in H4. So let's come back, and here we will add H4. And the title is comment. Let's say the number of comment, 134 comments. It is coming here. Next, we have to add the CSS properties for this one. Come to the CSS file, write this class name with description, then write H4. For this one, we will add font size. So the font size is 14 pixel. Then we will add the same color, and again we will add margin from the top. Let's say 15 pixel. So it is looking like this. After this title, we will add one comment box, and with that comment box, we will add one image and one input box. So just come back, come to the HTML file, and after this title, let's add space, and here we will add one div with the class name add comment. And in this one, first we will add one image, image file path. And after that, let's add one input box. Type it will be text, and let's add the placeholder. In this placeholder, we will add one message, write comments. You can see this image and this input box. Next, we have to add the CSS properties for this one. Let's copy this one, add comment. Here we will add the CSS properties for this one. So let's add display flex so that image and input box will be in the same horizontal line. Align items will be center, and we will add margin 30 pixel and 0. Copy this class name again. And in this one, we have added one image. So we will add the CSS properties for that image. For this image, we will add width, let's say 35 pixel, and border radius 50%, and margin from the right side. Now it is looking good. Next, we have to add the CSS for this input box. Copy this class name, then write input. For this input box, we will add border 0, then we will add outline 0 and border from the bottom. So there will be a line at the bottom, 1 pixel, solid, and this color code, width it will be 100%. Then we will add padding from the top, 10 pixel. Now you can see it is looking good. We have the white color over here for this input box, so we will add the background, let's say background transparent. Now it is fine. So we have added one input box with the image. Next we will add the list of comments, which is the old comment that is already there on this video. So let's come back, and after closing of this div, add comment, it is closing here. So here we will create another div. So let's add a div with the class name old comment. And in this one, again, we will add one image. Let's copy and paste it here. And after this image, we will add the comment. So let's add a div. And in this div, first we will add the name of the user who has commented on this video. So let's add a name in H3 tag. And with this name, we will add the time also. So let's add a span. And in this span, we will add time, 2 days ago. And after that, we will add the comment in p tag. So here I have added this text in the p tag. You can see the image, name, time and text. Next we will add the CSS properties for this one. So just come back and copy this class name old comment. Write it here in this CSS file. Here we will add display flex and align items center. Then we will add margin 20 pixel from top and bottom and 0 from left and right. In this one also we have an image, so let's add img tag. And for this image we will add width 35 pixel. After this width we will add border radius 50%, so that it will be a circle, and margin from the right side 15 pixel. Now you can see this image in the circular style. Next we will add the CSS properties for this name and this time. This time will be in small font size. So let's come back and write this class name. Then we will write the tag. So let's see, we have added the name in H3, so write it here. And in this one we will add font size 14 pixel. And then we will add margin from the bottom, let's say 2 pixel. Let's come back and copy this one. Then write H3, and in this H3 we have a span. So for this span we will add font size. It will be 12 pixel. Then we will change the color. This one, and font weight and margin from the left side. Now this time 2 days ago, it is also looking good. Now on this comment also, we will add some icons to like this comment, and we will display the list of replies on this comment. So let's come back and come to the HTML file, and after this p tag, you can see we have added the comment text in p tag. So after this one, let's add another div and we will add a class name. Let's add the class name comment action. And in this comment action, we will add image file path. It is like.png. So there will be a like icon to like this comment. And after that, we will add text in a span. Again, we will add another icon, which is image. It is dislike. And here also we will add a text in a span. Then we will add a text to add reply on this comment. So here we will add a span reply. Then we will add one a tag, and in this a tag we will add the text, which is all replies, to display all the replies on this comment. After adding these content in the comment action, let's refresh the website, and you can see one like image and dislike image, this text, this reply text, and this all replies link. Next, we have to design it using CSS. So let's come back and copy this class name comment action. Come to the CSS file. Here let's add the parent class name, which is old comment, then write the class name comment action. Here we will add display flex and align items will be center. Then we will add margin. Let's write 8 pixel and 0, and we will add font size 14 pixel. After that, copy this one, then write img. For this image, we will add border radius 0 and let's say width 20 pixel. And margin from the right side 5 pixel. Now you can see the size for these small icon, like and dislike icon, is good. Now let's come back and copy this one again, and in this one we have added a span. So let's add a span. And here we will add margin from the right side, margin right 20 pixel, and we will add the color. Now it is looking good. Next, we have to add the color in this a tag, which is all replies. So just come back and let's copy this one. Then write a tag. For this a, we will add color. Now you can see color in this link, which is all replies. Like this, we have added one comment and these action button on this comment. Next, we will add other comment also. So simply come back to the HTML file and duplicate this one, which is old comment. Select this old comment, copy and paste it again. Now you can see one more comment here. You can go and change the image, text, and name. After adding all these things, let me open this web page in a smaller screen. Now in this small screen, you can see we have good space from the left side, but in the right side, you can see we have some extra space. So let's come back and come to the CSS file. So come back to the CSS file. Here we will add media. Then let's add max width. (900px) and in this one we will add the CSS properties for smaller screen. So let's add the class name play video, and for this play video earlier we have added the flex basis 69%. We will add flex basis 100%. Now for the right sidebar also, here we will add flex basis 100. Now we will change the padding. So let's add this class name. Let's see what we have added. Here we have added the class name play container, and here we have the padding left 2%. So just come to the media query, add this class name play container. And for this one, simply add padding left 5%. Now you can see this width description is having more space from the left side. So we have to reduce this space. So just come back and copy this class name with description. Here we have added padding from the left side, which is 55px. So we will make it 0. Write this class name in this media query and let's add padding left 0. Next, you can see this text, which is views and 2 days ago, and this icon, like, dislike, share icon, save icon, these are touching each other. So we will add the CSS properties for this one. So just come back and let's add the class name. Let's see what we have written. Play video and play video info A. Here it is. So just copy this one . Write it here, and for this one we will add margin. Let's say margin left, it will be 0. Then we will add margin from the right side, it will be 15px. Then we will add margin from the top, 15px. After adding this, this section is also looking good. So now this web page is completely responsive for a smaller screen. Let's change the screen size like this, and you can see it is responsive. So now we have created the second page also, which is the video play page. Let's come back to the home page, and this is the home page, and let's click on this title of the first video and it will open the second page, and you can see the video is automatically playing. So we have completed this responsive web design for the website just like YouTube, And I hope this video will be helpful for you. If you have any question, you can ask me in the comment section. Please like and share this video and also subscribe my channel Easy Tutorials to watch more videos like this one. Thank you so much for watching this video.